When I think about my daughter, and when I think about the future of our church today, the work that I'm trying to do, the work that you're trying to do, the work that we are all doing in the Vineyard is for her. I'm a millennial, so our generation's a lost cause. Don't even worry about us. Gen Z, the current crop of high school and young college students, we still have a chance, I think, to engage and get them back on the same page of faith. But my daughter's generation, what some are calling Gen A, Generation Alpha, we just had to like start back over in the alphabet at this point, right? That generation is growing up in a time and in a world and in a church that we don't know what it's going to look like in the next few years, right? We're ever ancient and ever new. Our truths are not going to change, but the way we articulate those truths has to. The way we engage with the people sitting in our pews, 95 or almost two and everything in between, wants to be there and shows up all the time and was drugged there by their mom or goes because they don't really know what else they would have to do on a Sunday morning besides brunch. My generation has turned brunch into our worship. And I can't always complain. Bottomless mimosas are a good thing. I like them. They are almost sacramental. But we have to figure out a way to articulate that Mass comes first and then we go get the bacon and eggs, right? That Jesus should be the center of our lives because he is who we are drawn to relationship with. We are each called to be not just the hands and feet of Jesus Christ, but to be the voice and the mouthpiece of proclaiming the gospel, especially to young people who are beginning to disaffiliate in numbers that are quite alarming and scaring. Accompaniment calls us to get a little bit out of those comfort zones and actually pay attention to the person right in front of us, not just the program that we've written onto a paper. It forces us to pay attention to the individuals who are asking questions, who are confused and hurting, who are on fire and passionate and sometimes have way too many ideas and you just don't know what to do with them, and how we can love that individual into deeper relationship with Jesus Christ. It's relationship with someone so they are inspired to grow in relationship with the Lord.